Hello and welcome from the heart of hydraulics here in Lower Main. Today we have a special edition of the web seminars about safety first service. My name is Stefan Lehnert and I will host you for the next 45 minutes together with the expert Volker Tenhef that has brought very, very interesting information for you. I think some of you or most of you maybe haven't been to a web seminar with us before, so I explain you a little bit how this works. So besides from our live picture, you see the content that Volker has prepared for you, and downwards in the chat area you can put us your feedback, your questions, you can say hello from wherever you are, and I hope you're all safe. And as we want to have it as interactive as possible, we also prepared some questions for you. And just as a short warm-up, I would like to start with the first question. So please give us your vote. If you are a ship owner, a ship operator, an engine builder or a service provider or others. And if others, please write down in the chat area where you're coming from. So I see we have about 35 people online already. So please feel free to give us some information on whoever you are. So let's see, still about 15 people voting. I will wait for some more seconds. A lot of people from Bosch Rexroth and from supplier area. Hello to Canada. Okay. So then the next question. Did you ever work before with Bosch Rexroth service? So of course, please, if you are from Bosch Rexroth, don't vote. But for the others, please give us your information. If you know our services, if you know our offering, or if it's new for you. So also waiting now. Again, we must have about 35 people online, so feel free to give us your feedback. So only 7 people voted, but at least one hasn't been working with Rexroth before. Okay, so the topic today, we keep ships moving. Volker, I think very impressive topic, but my question would be to you, what is our input here?
Well, we not only want to keep ships moving, for us it's also very important to keep them moving safe. And that will be our focus for today, the topic safe.
Okay.
And yes, so we have seen some already have worked with us in service, but some not. But before we go into our topic into detail, we want to have a short look on our portfolio. And maybe I introduce myself as well before we spend the next minutes in sure. Our ship service topic. So my name is Volker Tenhef. I'm responsible for service sales in the business unit Industrial Hydraulics. So my main task is to assure that we offer the right services for our customers, so services which fit to the needs of our customers, and then of course also to sell these services on a global basis. And as I said, I want to start with an overview of our services, because when people talk about service, many are thinking just about spare parts. For me, it's important that everybody knows it's more than spare parts. So we offer repair for all components we are selling. We have a worldwide acting field service team. And in the field of retrofit, we are offering more and more kits with where you can replace an old component with a new component from us, including all the installation material, documentation, etc. In the field of fluid management, we are talking about, for example, rental oil treatment solutions, rental HPUs, rental citro box, and so on. Digital services, Stefan, you remember?
We had a web seminar about 2 months ago with your colleague Michael.
So only digital services like predictive maintenance, condition monitoring, our digital service assistant app, and in that field there's much more to come. Service agreements, of course, spare part management, also fixed price repair agreements, and the top of our agreements, I would say, is our industry service, where we are taking over the hydraulic maintenance tasks of our customer. And last but not least, of course, for service important 24/7 hotline, as well as a professional warranty procedure. So in case any component might not do what we are all expecting, we are there for you.
So keeping ships moving, what kind of sectors are in focus here?
Yes, let's have a look on the focus industries we are talking about now in the next minute. So for us, it's about the offshore part, so exploration, production, construction, as well as the marine part, so all kind of transportation vessels like container, tanker, bulk carrier, as well as cruise vessels, ferries, workboats, so quite a broad industry sector.
And I think even this morning also we have seen this is a very global business, I would say, so customers are spread worldwide. I think the setup with us, with your team or the service center is also a global one?
Yes, totally. So everywhere in the world there are companies who own vessels or who operate vessels. But additionally, these vessels are operating on a global basis. So they are driving around the whole world. And if we compare that to our network, to our global footprint, that's a very good match. On that slide, we see our marine repair centers. So we have many more service centers in the world, but they are usually focusing very much on the local market. In this global business, we are trying to connect them because, one customer can use several service centers. Therefore, these are the ones which are very close to the ports, who understand this industry very well. Mm-hmm. And one thing we want to offer you, and I believe that's very important, is one single point of contact. So if you are managing your vessels out of the US, we want to give you one contact in the US. If you're doing that out of London, we want to give you one contact in the UK. Mm-hmm. And that contact will be in touch with our service centers in the world.
And I can imagine there are a lot of different applications, even if it's mostly focused on these vessels, but what kind of applications do we talk about?
We will come to the applications right after that. Before we have a look on the applications which are relevant for hydraulic applications, I want to explain what we understand or what we see as the most important requirements for ship service. Mm-hmm. Then after my view, we will try to get to see what your view on that is. So when we talk about fast execution, I believe speed of a repair is very important, and the basis for speed is availability of spare parts. Mm-hmm. So right now we have, for example, several hundred FIFA valves, we have on stock. So they are available and we can replace them in case of failure. Or we have a dedicated pump spare part stock only for ship service in our service centers. In the field of reliability, I see mainly two aspects. So on one hand, it's very important that we can tell our customer upfront how long will it take a repair, for example. So will it take 1 week? Mm. Will it take 1 month? Pumps, for example, we can repair one set of pumps for a large engine in 5 days. And we just need to know 1 month ahead in which service center you want to do it. But a reliable answer on the question how much time is very important. Mm-hmm. The second aspect of reliability from my point of view is that we are the original equipment manufacturer. So we know these components. We have all data, all know-how, all access to the tools and so on. And we are also using only original spare parts, by that assuring that you get the same performance as you had before. Global presence, we just talked about. Lifecycle service is, we will show you many offerings, but we also want to show you how you can combine these several offerings over the lifecycle of your application, your vessel.
You promised me to bring some scenarios where we can see it in detail.
Yes, exactly. So many, many different options. Comprehensive portfolio, if you're working with a service provider, it's very important that you know what your service provider, what we can do and what we cannot do. So we have to understand our portfolio. We will work on that today. And last but not least, flexibility. Everybody in this industry has a lot of plans, but everybody knows that these plans are changing from time to time. So we have to live with that.
And as you said, we would like to learn from you now what kind of requirements are most important for you. So next question going up to you. What is the most important requirement for your hydraulic service provider out of these already explained?
Please or give us any vote. Other.
Of course. So I know that we have about 50 people now on the line. Please give us your feedback. We want to be a little bit more interactive, so we would like to learn from you if you are on the right page here. Okay, let's see. So fast execution, global presence definitely is an issue.
As well as reliability.
Yeah, but yeah, it's now
speed.
Getting a little more concrete, like in the session this morning, I think.
Yeah.
Fast execution, time is money, I would say. Okay, so now maybe?
Applications.
Now applications.
Now it's application time. So we saw the different types of vessels, but what they all have in common, also the offshore platforms, we have a lot of winch drives driven by hydraulic pumps and motors. We have all types of cranes. We have propulsion systems. We have thrusters. We have, especially in the transport vessels, we have hydraulic steering gear, cargo pump drives for the bulk carriers, as well as diesel engine systems for the transport vessels.
So again, question up to you now. Based on these applications, where would you see yourself? Where do you use components, especially from Bosch Rexroth? Okay. First votes are coming in. Looks like a kind of broad picture now. But still, okay, the winch drives.
Yeah, it's similar to the morning session.
Mm-hmm. We had a little more engine systems in the morning, but it also was winch drives and engines.
Winch drives, cranes, engines.
Yeah. And luckily, one of the top three you have prepared.
Yes,
so, more detail.
exactly. So we cannot talk about all these applications in detail. Therefore, we will make a deep dive in the diesel engine. And what you will see about the diesel engine, we can transfer that service approach also to all the other applications. So just see that as an example of how we are thinking, how we are working, and yeah. Let's go into detail in the diesel engine. So in the two-stroke diesel engine, usually there are our products FIFA valve, as we have here on the table, the A4 VSO pump as the high pressure system pump, HPS pump, as well as the startup unit. And what we want to look now in detail is first at the degradation of the pump. So what is happening with a pump when it's running in such an application? And then later on, what is happening with the FIFA valve over the time?
Mm-hmm.
So
start with the pump.
We start with the pump. We see it here. We see on top the position transducer, and below the metal cover, we see the proportional valve. And we have here some pictures of single parts of a pump after 5 years, so roughly after 32,000 running hours. And we see on the top left picture, we see a control plate, and we see first signs of cavitation. On the other hand, if we zoom out and look on the picture in the middle, it's barely visible. So it's really at the beginning. If we look on the swash plate, it's not a mirror, but it's shiny. There are some scratches. So also there's first little signs of wear, but it's still looking good. Cylinder rotary group from on that picture, there's with a human eye, there's not really anything visible. On the bearing shell, you see some color changes, but it's also still in rather good condition. So what we see is such a pump, or this pump, was running with very high oil quality, and that is the main factor to extend the pump lifetime. And now if we go to the next slide.
Five more years,
now 64,000 running hours. We see a lot of wear on all these parts. So on the control plate, we see a lot of cavitation. If we now look on the rotary group, on the cylinder in the middle, now we see that all holes around, they all mm-hmm. have a different shape. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we see one close up on the top right hand corner. So there is definitely everywhere cavitation. If we remember the swash plate, yeah, now if I just go back real quick, it was nice and shiny.
And now you can see the shape of the shell.
Now you can see exactly the shape of the bearing shell.
Yeah.
And you cannot only see it, if you touch it, you would also feel it.
Mm-hmm.
In the case of the control piston, yeah, it's very difficult to see the wear, but control piston is a typical part. We take the measurements during repair, and most probably this one is already out of limit, so would need an exchange.
So it's deformation or abrasion.
Yeah, it's just worn out, and the control of the pump would be unstable.
So that's the reality, that's the situation. So what would be your answer then from the offering perspective?
Yeah, that is definitely happening in all pumps. And as I said, depending on oil quality, it's happening earlier or
mm-hmm.
later,
mm-hmm.
but it's happening. And what are our offerings? How can we fix that? Or how can we work against that? So in the market, there are many offerings, just seals and bearings. Yeah, we don't offer that because our topic here is safety.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we want to be safe, or we want you to be safe on the sea. And what we are missing is the renewal of the position transducer and the proportional valve. So that is always in our offering because they are electronic components. And we have seen all the mechanical parts continuous wear leading to a continuous decrease of functionality. So the pump will have more leakage, will have more vibration, and so on. You can get a feeling out of that. The electronic parts, they will fail from now to the next moment.
So more critical.
They are more critical because when they fail, the complete pump is not working anymore.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to be safe, you have to exchange them. Therefore, in our overhaul light, always included, as well as seals and bearings. Inspection report, of course, you get it. We always test 100% with full pressure. And if we look on the schematic of the pump, we have indicated in blue color the parts we exchanged. So we see seals, bearings, and on top the position transducer and the proportional valve.
So that is called light overhaul.
That is our overhaul light.
And so what's the difference to the flat? Is it on the component level mainly?
Yes, so you can order that for a fixed price.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if we see that one of the parts already is worn out, any other part, then we would call you
mm-hmm.
and say, hey, this part is worn out as well, and we would charge it extra.
Okay.
If we look now on the overhaul flat, there you get full warranty on the complete pump, not only on the exchanged parts. And if we look into the same schematic, in the overhaul flat, also all green parts are included.
Mm-hmm.
So we will check if they need to be replaced or not. If yes, it's included.
Okay.
So you have completely upfront, you know what is the cost. There will be no extra charges.
So that's the idea of the overhaul.
That's the idea of the overhaul.
But I think there's another way, because you said this is based on having the products in stock or at your place.
The overhaul is always working like that. You have the component in your application,
mm-hmm.
in your engine. You take it out, you send it to a service center,
mm-hmm.
we repair it, we send it back, and then you can install it again and continue your travel, your working, and so on. So you have
mm-hmm.
a few days,
mm-hmm.
a few weeks without our component. And our next offering or last offering for pumps is the reman exchange, and that is working in a different way. And I will explain that on the next slide more in detail how it's working. We always have the classification included, so you can say if you need RENA or whatever, and you get a 2-year warranty. So how is reman working? In step one, the ship owner sends an order to us. I need 3 pumps. Then we take 3 pumps, which are already repaired, out of stock. We send them to you. And then you have, on your vessel, you have 2 sets of pumps and you can exchange them immediately. And then afterwards, you send us back your used pumps, we repair them, put them again into our stock. Mm-hmm. And there, in our stock, they will wait for the next customer. And for sending us back your pumps, you will get a credit note. So your cost is much lower than for a new pump. Mm-hmm. And there you see, this is the big advantage. You don't have that long waiting time because you can exchange immediately and continue work.
That's really keep ships moving.
Definitely. So there we reduce the time without engine, without crane, without winch a lot. So we have seen now all these offerings. Mm-hmm. And yeah, what does it mean for a ship owner or a maintenance planner? How can you combine all these offerings over the life cycle?
What's the classic approach? What's the normal way?
Our normal way, I will show that to you in the scenario one. So after 5 years, every vessel has to go into a classification docking, so into dry dock. We used to work here with reman. Mm-hmm. So we send you mm-hmm. a set of pumps, you exchange it. We do the same thing after 10 years. And after 15 years, you do again reman or you buy a new pump to cover the whole life cycle. As there's a lot of cost pressure as well in this industry, there was always the discussion, hey, is there another scenario? Another scenario could be scenario two. We start with an overhaul light. So if you take care of your oil quality, after 5 years, we can work with the overhaul light. We have a good chance that that is sufficient. After 10 years, you're again in the dock. We work with overhaul flat.
Replacing the whole. Yeah.
Replace all parts required for a fixed price. And then after 15 years, mm-hmm. reman, exchange it. At the moment, there are many discussions going on between ship operators and the engine builders in order to extend the first mm-hmm. maintenance interval to save further money. From our point of view, that is just an increase of risk.
It's like in the Formula One, keep the tires longer.
Yes, exactly. Just drive it longer. Hopefully, or there are cases where it works, but it's increasing the risk. The problem is after 48,000 hours, there's no docking. So you cannot work with the overhaul. We can offer you a reman, so that will work. Mm. You go into a port, you get your pumps, exchange it, and you continue your travels. And last but not least, of course, you can combine all these offerings as you like. Typical project approach is, for example, if you have similar or same sister vessels, start with reman, bring them onto the first vessel, take off the pumps, go over overhaul, bring them to vessel two, then repair vessel three, and so on. And you have to choose your scenario by judging the risk you want to take and also by judging on the cost for you to pay for the service provider, installation, logistics, planning, okay, etc.
Wow, so this, I think it's very flexible coming to the end, what we see here. I think maybe now, I know that you brought us a short impression on a I think it was a service center in
Singapore.
In Singapore. So maybe we should have a look at it.
We want to close the topic pump with a short overview or a short impression on our repair center in Singapore and then continue with the FIFA valve.
So for those of you that are following me on LinkedIn, I have seen yesterday we were talking about a big fellow and this is the FIFA valve. And I only knew FIFA from the soccer.
Yeah.
What does FIFA mean?
It's the fuel injection and valve activation valve. I will show that. So now it's time to talk about the FIFA valve. And here we see an animation of the function. So it has two main functions. On one hand, it's controlling the fuel injection. So, and by that, it has a huge impact on the overall fuel consumption of the vessel and also on the NOx emissions. And the other function is the exhaust valve activation. So nobody wants to have a valve which is opening too late and you get such high pressure that you risk a cover lift and your complete engine explodes. So that's also a very important function. And as you can see, it's not not very small. Yeah, it's quite a big valve. And there are four different brands in the market. What they all have in common is that they all have a main stage, which is here in the lower part, and they have a pilot valve. And usually most problems are caused by the pilot valve. It's simply like that. It's caused a lot by dirt in the oil, pollution. And the big advantage of our valve is that you can buy our pilot valve as a spare part and you can have it on board. And then if you have a problem with your FIFA valve, you can simply exchange the pilot valve first. It's plug and play, take it off, put the next one on. And in many cases, you have solved the problems without exchanging the complete valve, what you have to do with other competitor valves. And a second advantage for the user, for the engineer on board, is we have only one cable, not two. And we will see that later on. We have here in the pilot valve on top, we have a last chance filter. So it's a really small filter. It's the last chance to prevent dirt of coming into the pilot valve. And that's also saving us from many problems.
I like that name, last chance filter. I need that at home. With my coffee machine, for example. Okay, cool. Thanks for this insight. But so the offering itself is kind of similar to the pump?
Well, let's first have a look. What is happening? What is happening over 5 or 10 years with such a valve? So before we talked about electronics, and you don't see wear or anything. If you look on the picture of the control electronics, I think we all agree there is wear. This electronics does not look any new anymore. The problem is nobody knows how long will it work. One day, 1 week, 1 month, 5 years, we don't know it. So if you want to be safe, exchange it. Then on top you see the last chance filter. On the top right hand corner you also see that it's quite full with dirt. And yeah, that is one set of pictures. The other one here on the top row of pictures, we see the nozzle, which is here inside of our pilot valve, and it needs to be very accurate, and then it leads to very high or good dynamic behavior of the valve, accuracy, low hysteresis. And if it's worn out, the controllability of the valve is getting worse and worse. And you see very good on these pictures that this nozzle is wearing out over more and more. And on the lower section of pictures, you see the control spool of the main stage. So this is the big one, which is all in here. And the edges are very sharp because we have a very clear opening and closing point to control the fuel injection. And then you see after 5 years a little bit of wear, these very sharp edges, they're becoming round. And then at a certain point, they are so round that we cannot rework it anymore. So then this part has to be exchanged.
So I think maybe now it's also time to ask our participants again with the next question. So concerning the valve switch challenges, have you been confronted with before? Like the oil pollution or leakage, the temperature, or even the pilot valve itself. So what would you say here?
Yes, and we always see oil pollution, and oil pollution usually is leading to the other option, pilot valve. The main stage does not have so much problems because the pilot valve is very sensitive against oil pollution.
Yeah, it's kind of a clear indication that this is the main point. Okay, thank you for your feedback again. So now coming to the services, what is the offering here?
So what do we do to fight against this wear? So We recommend to do an overhaul after 5 years. In an overhaul in our service centers, we replace the electronic part. So we replace the pilot valve, position transducer, and the control electronics. And we rework housing and main spool. And there it's important to know that you cannot take out the main spool of one FIFA valve and put it into the next FIFA valve, because these parts are paired.
Mm-hmm.
So very low tolerances. And as I said, we check them in the repair and rework, usually. What does that mean over the complete life cycle of an engine? So we recommend to go after 5 years, so after 32,000 hours, to make an overhaul. Then 5 years later, so after 10 years, usually we cannot overhaul it again, mm-hmm. so we need an exchange. And then after 15 years, we can do the next overhaul. And in the meantime, of course, you have in every moment when you have a problem, you can use the pilot valve as the plug and play solution to exchange it and solve your problem, hopefully without exchanging the complete FIFA valve.
Cool.
So that was our deep dive on the diesel engine.
But you said before, it's not only limited to this area, so you're covering basically the whole application with these kind of services?
Yes, so all these applications are using pumps, motors, valves. The degradation is similar, maybe in some applications faster than in others, but we can also there we can combine overhauls, etc., to fit to your needs. And please talk to us if you need a service concept for any of these applications.
I think it's the right time, as we have no questions, so it looks like everything is quite clear what you have prepared already. So of course, I think the question would be from your side about this kind of information. So you will get the stack of slides, including the questions that we had in the morning, but also the questions that you may have for us. So we have still more time now. Give us your questions right now. But otherwise, of course, you will be able to have this information. So looking at the applications and what you've seen, so could you sum up again the advantages maybe?
Yes, so with our last slide regarding our topic here, an overview of our benefits. Yeah, we have seen global service network before. I talked about the single point of contact. You get a back to new warranty, and as we are the original manufacturer, you can be very sure that mm-hmm. We have done it right. So also that means minimal liability risks. Yeah, you don't go to a service company which is not certified and so on. What I find quite important is, especially in the case of reman, we are fulfilling all classification regulations. So we're doing the classification before we send the product to you. And I hope that we could show you that with a combination of our service offerings, you can also fulfill the maintenance intervals or the guidings, the recommendations of the engine builder, of the crane builder, of the winch builder, whatever OEM built your equipment. And yeah, I think these are the main reasons why we are the perfect partner for you to do service on your hydraulic equipment going offshore.
And finally, we get our first question right now. So from Luke, can we be sure that the overhauls are done within the docking time? So preparation, that's what you said before?
Yes, so for the pumps of the main engine, our standard offering today is if you call us 1 month ahead, we assure that we repair your 3, 4, 5 pumps of the engine within 5 days. And that is our standard offering. If it's an emergency, of course, it can be faster, mm-hmm. and then we do anything possible.
Mm-hmm.
But you call us 1 month before, tell us I want to have it done in Shanghai or in Istanbul or in Korea, and we arrange that.
Okay. So hopefully this answered your question, Luke. From Robert, what about field service? Are we sending our technicians on a regular basis to help customers remove and install our pumps and valves?
That is a very good question, and that I said before, comprehensive portfolio. So customer and service provider have to be clear what they can expect from each other. Mm. And that's exactly, that is a point where we have to go into a detailed discussion, because we cannot say that we can do that everywhere in the world. Mm-hmm. So we have some locations where we have field service technicians who have the know-how, who can easily access ports. If I think about Korea, for example, I don't see any problem that we could do that there. In any or in other regions, it's not 100% secured, so we need to talk about it. But I think that's a total normal okay. approach.
So feel free to give us more questions, but thanks already for this very, very impressive information, and especially to the insights. And I like the pictures also of the abrasion. So, and as Volker said, basically, I think it is a very individual approach, so you need to get into contact. So I think on the next slide, we see the possibilities here. Of course, there's a main email address where you can put in your requests 24/7, but also we have a nice comprehensive website, including all the information that you see above, brochures, white papers, even a nice blog post that we have on also for the mobile websites. And of course, there's a hotline, as you said, if it's getting into emergency, we are there for you. But be sure that our experts like Volker and also Nicolas, they are very active. The young generation is very active on social media. So you can get back to them also on LinkedIn. They are there for you. And yeah, thanks again for I think your feedback that we will get now. We will send out some more questions to you. I think the last thing that you need to know, we are doing several of these webinars. So if you have time, take a look on the website, and with the documentation, you will also get a link to the YouTube recording of the session here, so you can review it or you can give it to your customers as an information. So again, thanks for participating. Thank you, Volker, for your time, and stay safe. Hope to see us the next time.
Thank you very much. Goodbye.